Shukila. Apparently in Arabic, Shukila means the beautiful one. In Mandarin, it means kill the chicken. Fajila, no, kill the chicken. In Tamil, my mother tongue, it means nothing. You know, out of the millions of memes from Mahabharata, Bhagavad Gita, Bharatanatyam, my parents gave me a name with no meaning. Much like the story of my life, you know. You know, people say comedy is tragedy plus time. Looking back at my life, it has been one very long comic relief for those around me. It's okay, you can laugh at my misery. That's why you paid money to come, right? But you know what? I think I'm in a very good position to do comedy. I'm a special education teacher, which means I have a knack for speaking to people with special needs. You know, I think we all got some form of special need, you know. We need to be loved, we need to be respected, we need to be appreciated, and sometimes we need a kick in the butt. That's where I come in, I'm Indian, which means I'm very good at playing the victim. In fact, that is my game plan today. Some people call me coconut. I find it very offensive, you know. Am I brown, round, and hairy? Okay, don't answer that. I'm a little bit hairy, a little bit round here and there. But that doesn't mean you can call me nut, okay? The truth hurts, people. The truth hurts. You know, people say, being Indian in Malaysia is hard. Oh, sorry, I have to go back a bit. I feel for my Indian machans, you know. They tell me that they are always profiled. Aside from the society at large, sometimes their own people, own family profile them, you know. Macha means brother, Indian brother. You know, Macha got long hair. Darzla, Urpuriya Mata. Translation, useless because got long hair. Hey, hello. All the Indian gods all got long hair, you know. In fact, I think I do. Lord Shiva is the one who started the man bun movement, you know. Now hipsters all got man bun, Oh, that one, okay, hypocrite, right? But what I'm trying to say is, not all Indian machas are bad. Some are really good. Mummy loving wife beating alcoholics. Inda kada poduma, unna konjo venuma. Inda kada poduma, unna konjo venuma. Translation. You want to hear some more story or not? Hey, you want or not?
Yeah.
Okay, if you say no one also, I'll still continue. I'm holding the mic, ma. Hey, you know, I want to tell you something about Tamil, since I sang a little bit Tamil song. Oh, by the way, it's not Chaya Chaya, it's Chaya Chaya. You know, last time the Tamil old songs all are very beautiful, very, the words all are very polite, very beautiful. Aptus, I will sing one song for you. But don't worry, I will translate for you. And I won't translate like some jokers, you know, they'll translate all the nonsense. You know, they will tell you, Sutu means wild flower. No. Sutu means the only flower. Okay? Here goes. Naan malarodu thaniyaga yeningu nindre en maharani unaikkan ododi vandhen. Translation. I stood by the roadside next to the big huge train. With a rose in my hand, I came running to meet you, my queen. Beautiful, beautiful. Okay, nowadays love song. Why this colour berry be? Why this colour berry tea? I can go on, half the song is just these two lines only. First of all, very disrespectful, you know, to call somebody D. Half the song is in English. And you know the meaning, the meaning. Why this rage to kill somebody? Love song. Love song. But I have to tell you, all these Tamil songs nowadays, all sounds, only sounds. And then they put in some nice beat and then it will become a hit, like sometimes go viral and all that. All sound with no meaning. Much like my name. La. So, let me come back to my story. You see, people say being Indian in Malaysia is hard. But let me tell you, being Indian woman divorced with no children is hell. In my mid-20s, I made the biggest mistake of my life. I got married. Okay, let me ask, any married couple in the house? Yeah. Show of hands, married couple. One, two, and that one my boss. You see, that is the problem. Married couples don't come and watch comedy. Hey, how to make your marriage last so long if you don't laugh at yourself? You have to, guys, you have to. Tell your friends, come watch comedy. Your marriage will last longer. You know, back to my story. It was all okay, no? It was all okay. Until I got divorced. I realized I became a double threat, you know. All the while, I've been a threat to women with partners, you know. Given my raw inherent beauty, Why you laugh? Why you laugh? The bio, no? Okay, no, continue. Let me continue. Okay, let me continue. When I became a special threat to married Indian women. No, I just smile at the husbands. La. I just smile at the husband. Ayo, she's stealing my husband. She's stealing my husband. Hello, Akka. You give me free also. I don't want, okay? It's like a chicken that escaped from KFC, us going back and saying, catch me, catch me, catch me. Why? Why would I do that? Why? No need, no need. Keep. But you know, that is not the worst. The worst is got no children. Now, this very beautiful case, you know. No husband, no children. You better marry some old man and take care of him, lah. At least when he dies, you will get some money. Yes, ladies and gentlemen. Became divorced, I also became asexual, no feeling upstairs, downstairs, you know? Actually, the opposite happened, you know, but that story I save for another day, But you know, I discovered something that kind of changed my life. I discovered comedy. And at this juncture, I want to say something. I want to acknowledge this person in the audience, you know? You see, I've been training with him for me, officially. Until today, I have not paid him a single cent, you know. He is doing all these workshops out of his goodness of his heart. This type of species is very rare. So please join me in thanking my seafood, Monty. Okay, where was I? Oh yeah, I discovered comedy. You know, one of the things are very important for comedians is to observe people, okay? But you know, at my age, if I start gazing at men for too long, I will get different label one, you know. So I started watching women. And I discovered something. Women, you all got to chill. You all got to lighten up, you all got to relax. You know, shopping mall, you say, okay, husband, wife, two, three kids, you know. Husband, cool, you know, enjoying the view. Sometimes the view like that, you know. Husband. Wife, mother. Hey, don't run. Come again. Hey, don't run. Wait, you want to go shishi, Come, let's go shishi. Go toilet. I never bring you. You come out. Women. Yo, chill. Sometimes let your husband be the one to panic. You know, your child run 1 kilometer, let him chase after the child. Let him be the one to show off a little bit. Okay, you are like, cool, okay. And then the other one, I discovered. This one, this advice is for all women. Don't be that other woman. And by that other woman, I don't mean that other woman, you know. I mean that nosy auntie that everybody has. You know, me that Rosie auntie. You know, in my case, I'm a bit special, you know. Everybody got one or two nosy aunties. Huh? My mother got five sisters. My mother, okay, you know, my mother, cool. The auntie will come, you know. Why your daughter not yet married, huh? Why your daughter every day go out with different guy, huh? Hello, auntie. It's not different guy, la. It's different grab car driver. Hello. Okay, before I go, I want to end with this, you know. I have to tell you this. Nowadays, my relatives, the aunties, all, don't talk nonsense to me every day, you know. You know why not? They know that I do comedy. So, anything they say can and will be used against them on this comedy stage in one way or another.